maybe have some information about the background of, I think it's F.O.R.
F.O.R. is an organization which started its work in Europe almost 100 years ago. And then after 10 years, they moved to America, and now they have 80 branches. Anytime America had any problem with any specific country, Iran today, people in America, people who were pro-peace, they started to make a connection, people to people. And these days we call ourselves civilian diplomats. In this trip we have 22 Americans, all of them are from different backgrounds. They want to know Iranian culture better and they want to make a connection, people to people, which is in this critical momentum, as you mentioned, in American and Iranian relationship, it is really vital to have these relationships.
Every single one of us on this delegation feels very strongly and actually works in the United States to promote peace as an outcome rather than any use of war.
An attack by the United States government on Iran would be a catastrophe. We will explode the Middle East. We will raise violence around the world. What we need to do is to negotiate.
Americans want to know Iranian culture better. We are here because we want to know the culture.
I actually like to remind the women that it's very important that our headscarves covering our hair. I know it's difficult to hear sometimes through the headscarves, and that we should not be showing any of our throat.
The most dangerous thing in this country is crossing a road. Don't cross the road alone. If you are on yourself, you can go along and you can cross with the local people.
This is the mausoleum of the holy man, the saint, in Shiite belief, Ali ibn Hamza, who is a nephew to our eighth Imam, Imam Riza. This holy shrine is one of three holy shrines in Shiraz, and it was built in early 10th century. As were or mirror were, and the inside is so glorious and very unique to the Shiites, and we only have this type of mausoleums and decorations in Iran and nowhere else in the world.
There's no greater poet of love on earth. He's in the category of Shakespeare and Goethe. Everyone has two books in Iran. One is the Quran and one is the Divan of Hafez.
It's flowers, the scents, the aromas, the oranges, everything. It's meant to be a sensual landscape where one indulges one's passions, where one indulges one's philosophy, where one is encouraged to have the most expansive types of experiences possible.
The way he has expressed the idea of love, love for the beloved, love for the friend, Lovers in the Tea House is simply a dream come true for me. And to be here is a great honor. I never thought in my lifetime I would make it to Shiraz.
The name of this place is Mehre Gohar va Mehraban.
Va ba kirdar nik zindagi bokunim ta jahani dashte bashim bar sulh va dosti va safa va salam.
We want the whole world and the whole human being to have a good and peaceful coexistence with each other according to the beliefs of Zoroastrianism, which is good talking, good thinking, and good behavior. So according to this Iranian constitution, it says that all religions of Judaism, Christianism, Zoroastrianism can practice their own beliefs according to their own religion. They have a representative in the parliament of Iran, and up to now they have had some differences in terms of the compensation law. If someone is getting run over by a car, get killed or something, then they get less compensation than a Muslim. But they have changed the law in the parliament, and now so almost everything is the same.
Behruz Nikdin. Yes, he's a religious man of Zoroastrians.
Every Saturday, almost 300 people come here for prayer, and this floor belongs to men and upstairs women. We have a freedom, we can practice our religion, and we don't have any problem. We consider ourselves as an Iranian, and I think Muslims have a special respect for us here.
Are Jews able to become influential in the government or parliament or in important jobs in the government?
There are many Jews who are working for the governmental offices, but the highest level is in a parliament, and we have a parliament representative.
This area in Esfahan is called Julfa, the place, the quarter of Esfahan in which the Christian, the Armenian live. For those who live around this area, they come here every Sunday for their religious part. This is the church of 17th century, in time of Shah Abbas, King Abbas the First. We have a dome because the Muslims architects were the builder of the church, and it shows the mix of Islamic architectural features and also the European, the paintings on the wall done by the Christian, by the Armenian themselves.
Do the religious minorities have some sort of registration so that the government knows how they are identified? Or is it more?
No, that one is the most problematic part. You know, you don't have to declare that you are a Jew, and there is no sign to show that you are a Jew or Christian. For Armenians, it's a little bit much more clear because of the names. Like, see the name of this man, Haygas. If I hear this name, I know immediately he's Armenian.
Represent the Fellowship of Reconciliation, an interfaith, non-violent organization committed to peace between our two nations.
من اولا خیلی خوشحال هستم که شما رو زیارت
In the name of God, the merciful, I'm so happy that I have this meeting with you.
Jumhuri Islami Iran.
The Islamic Republic of Iran, 1979, was born. The Islamic Republic and I've come to ishq-e be dunya arz-e bokunam, to present world with love. The policy right now is based on something which only believes in profit.
Sirfan manafe iqtisadi ro mibine.
Not mentioning culture, not caring about culture.
Be insan tavajjuh nadare.
And not caring about humanity.
Un insan ro misl mashin mibine.
So they say a human as a machine.
Iqtisad jalbe nadare.
And we don't see any of love in their economy.
Insan hamash ishq.
And humanity is all love.
Hamash bavare.
And all belief.
Hamash hisse.
And all emotions.
Ina dar siyasat niest.
And these are not present in policy. But the others who have no love for people.
Manafe khudishun nemidunan.
And they don't think about the people's goodness are condemned to defeat.
Be mardom-e dunya hukumat konan.
Believers should lead and should rule people of the world.
آدمایی که عشق وجودشون رو پر کرده.
The people who have love.
اما اونقدر علیه اون تبلیغ کردن.
But there is so much propaganda against it.
اون رو مظهر خشونت معرفی کردن.
And they have introduced it as a sign of violence. Yes.
سیاستش اینه که روابط بین دو ملت رو برقرار.
Nowadays, the policy of the Iranian government is to make connections between two nations.
برای همین آقای دکتر احمدی نژاد پیشنهاد کرد که پرواز مستقیم بین تهران، نیویورک و تهران، واشنگتن به نظر ما.
There should be a direct flight between Tehran and New York or Washington, probably.
اگر مردم آمریکا بیان ایران،
if the American people come to Iran and they see Iran and get acquainted with the people here،
با معاون رئیس جمهور آشنا بشن،
and also get to know the vice president،
چی میشه؟
So what will happen؟
میفهمن اونا خیلی دروغ گفتن تو این سال‌ها.
So they will understand they have been lied up to now.
راجب همه چیز.
About everything.
راجب پیشرفت این مردم.
About the state of progress seeing of the people.
راجب فرهنگ این مردم.
About the level of the culture of people.
راجب اعتقادات و باورهای این مردم.
About the beliefs of these people.
راجب اخلاقیات این مردم.
About the morality of these people. Iranian people like you very much.
Iranians will seek for nuclear energy no matter what the price, but are ready fully to be monitored by whatever international rules and regulations and whatever additional protocol which exists in this world. We would like to be treated fairly.
What is going on here is that Iranians want to have nuclear energy for producing power, electricity. Which law, which international law can prevent these people from having access to this technology? And no document is shown to show that Iran is going to create a weapon of mass destruction from this energy. This is just what you hear from Western media. There is no evidence for this.
United Kingdom, other countries use nuclear energy because it has some good parts to it as well. It's not always the peaceful nuclear energy is always bad. It has a good part to it. And religious, according to our religion, using nuclear weapon is prohibited. And I think it's clear that this country is a kind of religious country and not going to do anything. And the base is religion, so it's not going to do anything against its base to have nuclear weapons. And the history showed that we never used such kind of activities to kill people in mass numbers as what had happened in Japan. So I think just saying, okay, you don't have, it's kind of stopping the country from progressing. because we need the energy to progress. So it's not to say, okay, since nuclear energy is connected to the nuclear weapon, you don't have to have it. Nobody says the same thing about Israel, for example. They have the nuclear weapons and they produce it, this. And people of the United States, I think most of you, paid for that from your taxes.
این توقع است که از روشنفکران تاریخ‌دانان آمریکایی و اروپایی که روشنگری بیشتری بکنند از حق دفاع کنند.
He said that God is going to help whoever's trying to do what's right, whether they're in Iran or whether they're in the United States. And in Iran, if by any chance our government should try to produce weapons, atomic weapons, we would hope that the cultured people and the religious people in this society would protest and would stand up against any such kind of action. And we hope that the cultured and religious people in America would also stand up against any kind of action that the American government would want to take against us when we're only trying to get what's our right for the production of energy.
I imagine that you've heard that there has been quite a bit of controversy regarding the Holocaust conference that was held here in December, and we would really like to know what your thoughts are about that conference.
I thought the Holocaust conference was just horrible. It didn't accomplish what it was supposed to. What was trying to be accomplished was to pick a sore spot in the West and to say, look, you're accusing us of not allowing for freedom of speech and things like that here, but yet you don't do that either because you don't allow scientific and open discussion of the Holocaust. But the people who were invited, some of them were just out and out racists. And the people who did the inviting were mostly just looking for whoever they could find who was critical of the Holocaust and not looking into the background of these people. So the whole thing ended up backfiring.
No one in Iran denies Holocaust. The purpose of conference was not to deny Holocaust, but some people say, many people in the West as well, that the story was exaggerated. The second point is that it has happened and a bad thing happened. Why Palestinians should pay the price for this? This is not acceptable. But many people have questioned about the dimension of it. And it must be free people for researchers to do research, to find what was the problem and what was the extent of tragedy that happened. It is not acceptable that we, you know, forbid people to do research and to express what they found.
I hope that from the other people that you've talked to, that you've mentioned this issue with, you got a variety of opinions about it. I mean, I know that when I talk to lots of my friends and teachers in Rome, I found that there was, I said to them, like, do you know who David Duke is? And they said, no, we have no idea. And I said, well, you know, on his website, he says that Chinese civilization was founded by white people. Now, you know, that's not the kind of thing that Islam should be promoting or that should be promoted in the name of Islam. And we should distance ourselves from people that hold those kind of views. And generally, I found that people here had no idea what that was about. On the other hand, talking with younger people, I found that there was also not very much information about what the Holocaust is all about, and I think that there needs to be more education about that here as well.
In the name of God, the compassionate, the merciful. Hello, everyone, and welcome to this edition of Iranian and English News with me, Nima Chitsas. First, the headlines. U.S. Marines fleeing an insurgent ambush in Afghanistan open fire on civilians, killing 16 people. The Kuwaiti cabinet resigns after only 8 months in office. China tells the U.S. not to send the wrong signals to Taiwanese separatist forces. And Iranian women condemn American attempts to censor Muslim voices at the recent UN conference.
If you look at the past 200 years of history of Iran, you haven't seen a single case of Iran's attitude to invade a neighbor. You know, Iran has 14 countries, neighboring countries. I think it's unique in the world, with just diversity of neighbors. And having Iraq on your one side and Afghanistan on the other, then having a stable country in between here. Islam is peace. Salam is peace. Peace is our motto.
رحمت و مهربانی است و برادری و برادری است.
What he says is that if we look at basic teachings of Islam and particularly at Shiism, we find that the teachings about peace and avoiding violence is very clear, because it's taught that all of us should strive to be manifestations on earth of the mercy of God, and that we should try to promote brotherhood among all people. One other thing that we can do as Americans in concert with Iranians is pray for one another. I believe that prayer is very important, and I found that praying, Christians and Muslims praying together and fasting together, is a very powerful spiritual force. And I believe that that can work wonders for them.
The way I see it, the United States wants to create tensions, regional tensions, and mobilize its public opinion to sell weapons. So $491 billion military budget, that equals to the military budget of all countries in the world, says a lot to us. You know, Russia spends a lot, but its military budget is $30 billion. Think about it. So the danger, I'm sorry to say that, the danger is right behind your ears in Washington, D.C. If they overwhelm Iran, they're going to go somewhere else, because they need wars to sell weapons. It's not the question of nuclear energy. If there was nuclear, there wasn't nuclear energy, there was something else they pick in order to overwhelm Iran. That's the logic that they use. I'm sorry to say this. So when there is a war, only a few people get rich. But when there is a peace, maybe there are more people who get from it. I don't know even one person in Iran from all 70 million people who are looking for any kind of tensions or conflict with any people in the world. They all want peace, all of them. The world has a lot of problems. We don't need any more tensions. That's the message we want.
My message to Americans, to American people, to American officials is that please don't make another war. That's enough for us. That's it.